And welcome to this Business and Economics Faculty of the University of Auckland. Our official proceedings will begin shortly. They'll begin when your graduands will enter the auditorium, and at that point you'll be invited to stand. They'll then be followed by the official party, which includes the academics who taught your students. As the official party enters, we invite you to join the singing of the traditional graduation song, Gaudiamus. Please then take your seats when the Chancellor takes his seat. Very important message, if you're currently carrying a cell phone, please ensure it's either turned off or turned to silent. And whilst you're very welcome to take photos during the procession and during the ceremonies, please move back to your seat immediately so you don't obstruct anybody behind you. And please don't stand in the aisles to take photos. At the end of the ceremony, the Chancellor will invite the gathering to sing God Defend New Zealand with your new graduates. Please remain standing following the end of the anthem as the processions leave the auditorium. Once the last graduates have left, you'll also be invited to leave. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for your students.
Thank you. Australia, please. Please be seated. Enga mana, enga reo, enga hau e wha. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Council Members, Special Guests, Staff, Graduands, Family and Friends of Graduands. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of Council Members and Staff of the University. In particular, I welcome our guest speaker, Dr. Peter Rajsingh. I also acknowledge the recent passing of Dr. Merimeri Penfold, who was a long-term member of the University of Auckland staff, a distinguished Māori scholar, and for many years, the kuia at our graduation ceremonies. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week, we will be conferring and awarding more than 6,572 qualifications on some 6,478 students in person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 464 students will graduate in person and 157 students will graduate in absentia. I will be assisted by Mr. Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor. This is a happy and memorable occasion for you, the graduands, as well as your families and friends who have supported you during your studies. We congratulate you all. Equally, your achievement brings pleasure and satisfaction to the academic and professional staff of the university who have played their part in your success. Capping is a time for celebration. The graduation procession today brought academic flavour and colour to the streets of Auckland, and in this ceremony you'll experience the pomp and tradition befitting your well-deserved day of celebration. Over a period of 130 years, the University of Auckland has become a comprehensive research-led university with a strong international reputation. Today, there are more than 40,000 students and 5,000 staff. Moreover, we are New Zealand's largest research organisation, with one-third of the country's externally rated world-class researchers. Within New Zealand, only our university is ranked within the top 1% of the world's universities. We also have a strong commitment to Māori education. Of all the Māori degree graduates in New Zealand each year, 25% come from just one institution, the University of Auckland. For Pacifica graduates, the number is closer to 40%. The quality and international reputation of a university are fundamentally driven by the achievements of its people, and last year was an exceptional one for our academic staff, who won almost every form of recognition available to them in New Zealand. In July, Professor Alison Jones and Associate Professors Bryony James and Katha Simpson won national tertiary teaching excellence awards for sustained excellence in tertiary teaching. These awards mean that for 11 of the past 12 years, our researchers have been recognised as amongst the best, the very best in the country. In November, engineers, distinguished Emeritus Professor John Boys and Professor Grant Kovic won the Supreme Award at the Prime Minister's Science Prizes Awards for their work on inductive power transfer. Dr. Ben O'Brien from the Auckland Bioengineering Institute won the McDiarmid Emerging Scientist Prize for his groundbreaking work on artificial muscles. And Dr. Susie Wiles from Molecular Medicine and Pathology won the Science Media Communication Prize. Our staff also excelled at the 2013 Royal Society of New Zealand Awards, winning 4 major medals. The most notable was distinguished Professor Dame Anne Salmon from Māori Studies, winning the Society's highest honour, the Rutherford Medal. This was awarded for her eminent work on Māori social structures and interactions within the European world, and on European exploration in the Pacific. She was also named Kiwi Bank New Zealander of the Year for 2013. These achievements reflect the outstanding quality not only of our academic staff, but also of the students who work with them and the many professional staff who support them. A key part of our challenge for the future, and one that is clearly reflected in our strategic plan, is to continue to invest in a community of highly accomplished staff and students. An important element of that investment is ensuring that our teaching facilities are of the highest quality. To this end, the Council completed in 2013 the purchase of the former Lion Brewery's site in Newmarket as the basis for a new campus which will be integrated with the City and Grafton campuses. At Newmarket, work is well underway on construction of the engineering research laboratories. These buildings represent an investment of approximately $88 million to support our engineering research and postgraduate teaching for the benefit of all New Zealand. We will occupy the first of these new facilities in July this year. Work has also begun on the new science tower on the corner of Wellesley and Simon Streets. This major construction project represents an investment of more than $300 million. It will allow us to upgrade science teaching and research and integrate the School of Psychology and the School of Environment into the main science precinct. This will in turn free up the Human Sciences Building for refurbishment as a centre of the arts faculty. Constant innovation is the cornerstone of a university such as ours. Innovative teaching and research is vital for long-term, sustainable economic growth of our country and social cohesion of our nation. This has never been more so in the testing times we face in the wake of the global recession, the Christchurch earthquakes, and the yet-to-be-defined effects of global warming. Universities equip graduates like you not simply for the jobs of today, but for future careers not yet imagined in an ever-changing world. So as you graduate today, please reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and consider the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. Reflect on the changes in technology you have already experienced in your lifetime, and remember that most of the technology you will use in your future working career has yet to be developed or commercialised. I ask you to do this because we can never rest on our laurels, especially in a challenging and ever-changing world. Whatever path you follow as you go out into the world, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, we should be spending more on universities, not less. So don't worry, we will be in touch with you, and when we do, please lend us your support. But that is enough of the substantial issues facing us all as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations. Because today is your day, with a focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we'll honour your success along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. It is indeed a pleasure for me to welcome this morning's guest speaker, a celebrated teacher, an international speaker, and I'm proud to say, a graduate of the University of Auckland. He is also the chair of the Friends of the University of Auckland in North America. Dr. Peter Rajsingh sets an example for us all to follow. He was educated in New Zealand, finishing high school at Whanganui Collegiate, and then graduating from the University of Auckland in 1986, when he was awarded the senior and annual prizes in politics. He has a PhD from the Graduate Centre of the City University of New York and has taught at New York University's Gallatin School of Individualized Study since 1991. It is a tribute to his passion and drive that he has received 4 outstanding teaching awards from the university during his inspirational career. Peter is also annual visiting professor at the Naoma Management School in Rennes, France. He teaches undergraduate and graduate courses in finance, business ethics, social and political philosophy, and US constitutional law, as well as interdisciplinary seminars focused on politics, philosophy, and economics. He is a partner at alternative asset management firm in New York, co-founder of a media and entertainment startup, and also serves on the boards of a number of private companies and charitable institutions. Welcome, Peter. We're delighted to have you with us today.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of the Council, members of the University, graduands, families, and friends. Kia ora koutou katoa. Heartiest congratulations to our graduands, accomplished, celebrated, intelligent sparks of pure potentiality. It's an extraordinary honour and delight to be with you all today. Here in New Zealand, over 20 years since going to live in New York, I can't help but be moved by being back in this country and at this university, both of which played a deeply formative role that prepared me for many later challenges and opportunities. You can leave New Zealand, but New Zealand never leaves you. I'm sure you too will look back in years to come, as I constantly do, recalling your time at Auckland University as some of the most wonderful moments of your lives. With due credit to David Foster Wallace, from whom I've borrowed and adapted this, I'd like to share with you a little fable. Imagine 2 young native New Zealand birds chattering atop a beautiful potakawa tree. Their playful banter is abruptly cut short when an older relative, imagine, you know, an annoying uncle from Rotorua or something like that, flies up and joins them. "Good day, fellas," he exclaims. "How's the air up here?" The young birds look at each other, puzzled, and then one retorts to the other, "What the heck is air?" Let's reflect upon the message here. As we proceed through life, it's easy to begin taking things for granted, to become complacent and simply not perceive the stuff around us that enables us to live and breathe. When learning to fly, young birds must negotiate the critical relationship with air. But once the skill feels mastered, the relevance of the air in which birds swoop and swarm seems to fade into an inconsequence. I'd like to suggest to you that air, for all of us here today, is a worthy ongoing metaphor, and I'm going to stretch the metaphor throughout this talk. For one thing, in New Zealand, where clean and fresh air is found in relative abundance, we often don't realize how precious a commodity air really is. But I'm interested in another interpretation of air. We can also consider that a first-class tertiary education, such as the one we've been privileged to receive at Auckland University, is also a form of air, an elemental experience meant to continuously refresh and oxygenate the spirit. Education, like air, is something we must never disregard nor forget. In an age where everything tends to be commodified or treated instrumentally as a means to an end, we lose sight of significant aspects of what an education stands for, such as its relationship to the contemplative life of the mind and the responsibilities that come with it. For the ancients, this was a given. Education and intellectual virtue are ends in themselves and freighted with serious moral purpose. For this point, too, birds provide important lessons. In their long migrations, birds fly in V or J formations, conserving energy by taking advantage of wind fields created when the wing motions of their fellows in front help propel the ones behind along. When those at the head of the formation tire, other birds take the lead, their actions helping others in the flock. The efforts of the leaders contributing to pulling along all the others. This image perhaps reflects part of the moral purpose of an education. It prescribes a duty to contribute positively, putting knowledge to work in a responsible way in the service, not only of ourselves, but for the greater good. One of the misunderstandings that sometimes arises when you come from a small and airy country is the idea of not mattering, of being irrelevant in the larger world. Here again, we must remember our two young birds on top of the potikawa tree. Air, that stuff in which we move, can simply never not concern us. We change our air by the way we navigate through it, creating various kinds of ripples and slipstreams. Whatever we do has relevance for the people around us and the broader society writ large. And so it is with how we choose to live, the goals we set, and the purposes to which we dedicate ourselves. From the time of the great migration of the Maori to Aotearoa, Kiwis have been venturing into unknown lands and excelling. This is an enduring national ethos. Consider notable New Zealanders, Edmund Hillary, Catherine Mansfield, Lord Ernest Rutherford, Kiri Te Kanawa, Graham Liggins, the list goes on and on. All these people were holding their own on the global stage. At the same time, being geographically removed from global groupthink has distinct advantages. New Zealanders are possessed of a unique sense of proportion, practicality, creativity, and common sense. It's imperative we never lose what's distinct and special about New Zealand, and incumbent upon you, the future generation, to ensure that New Zealand does not allow itself to stray. By forgetting what is our air and thereby replicating dystopian social realities found elsewhere in the world. Untenable circumstances are commonplace, from dark social inequalities to massive indebtedness, political corruption, food and water insecurities, environmental degradation. All these things we know too much about. Those of you who will become future leaders must try to develop more sustainable ways of being, both social economic, and political, cognizant of how aspects in contemporary life have placed us upon a slippery slope. My connection to New Zealand was a lucky accident. At 15, I wanted to go away to boarding school and had never been to New Zealand, which was maybe part of the appeal. But ultimately, I can probably credit coming here also on a bird. I was around 6 or 7 when a Kiwi friend of my parents gave me a vinyl EP of Alwyn Owen's Pookie and the Birds Singing Contest. I don't know if any of you know it. This introduced me to the idea of New Zealand. I can't really remember much of the plot, but the song of the tui on the record, which went something like this, is still lodged in my mind. This random encounter with New Zealand birds turned into an education. And this carries a lesson for me. Life is as much about lucky coincidences and confluences as it is about purposeful effort and active agency. We must learn how to combine conscious effort with natural progression. Properly using your wings is important, but then there are air currents that come out of nowhere, which catch you and cause you to soar, gliding and ascending to heights you could never imagine. And all the while, as we travel, we must have an ongoing sense of gratitude for those things that are our air, their quality and buoyancy, literally and figuratively. We should also ever recognize and acknowledge the array of facts, some solidly positive, some bad even, that cannot be taken for granted or ignored. This is how we open ourselves up to concrete and abstract qualities that constitute our air, making and remaking ourselves in the existential flight called life. Before concluding, I'd like to share a quick piece of information. Make a note of a number, 09215-6754. It's for a place on Karangahape Road where you can go to get your unwanted tattoos removed. Graduands, congratulations, and please take this message to heart. Be vigilant and mindful, and remember what is air. Fly high, lift those around you, and land well. Thank you.
Thank you, Peter, for a most challenging and insightful speech. Can I ask you to join with me again in thanking Peter for that address? This is a meeting of council and convocation of the university at which the Pro-Chancellor, Peter Kiley, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Deputy Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Wong, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Deputy Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Business and Economics. To the degree of Bachelor of Business and Information Management, Joshua David Adie. Jordan Michael Atkins. R.J. Christian Balani. Arjol Abias Bartolome. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Linda Block. Rohan Zubin Dalal. Joshua David Elder. Xiao Xiao Fan. Dianel Anthea Almena Jinto. Emily Louise Hayden. Han Ho. Michelle Blair Hooper. Liesl Victoria Kallian. Crystal Rio Pinnell Lapis and a Graduate Diploma of Commerce. James Matthew Law. Lily Lee. Oliver Niels Warwick Marsh. Khan Chua Nyon. Afiani Douglas Okpala. David Jonathan Perry. Dustin Sean Tan Pinada. Anchita Sharma. Yu Teng Shun. Lisa Jane Strong. Rebecca Susan Mari Van Altvust. Haley Marie Watson. William Thomas Andrew Whelan. Christine Naira Mary Withington. Jonathan James Young. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Abdul Sayez Abbas. Oliver James Agnew. Sue Jun An. Faisal Ali. Ashayini Amarasingham. Roshan Anand. Arani Thulasi Anabaskaran. Nessa Anau. Ryan Latham Anderson. Dexter Fernandez Angelo. Julian John Hayes Anya. Sean Matthew Ansell. Akash Velkani Sharian Anthony. Marvin Antonio. Matthew Alistair Thompson Arbuckle. Holly Rebecca Armstrong. Frances Colette Arns. Scott Michael Ashby. Vivian L. Vanya Babich. Syed Fabud Badri. Min Hun Bai. Sean Jin Bai. Benjamin Neil Bakalich. Ki Ying Bang. Carl Hamilton Barnhill. Eugene Olegovich Basai Kin. Abul Khair Mohammed Muskid Bashir. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Michael Boyer Bellingham. Jenna Marie Bentley. Olivia Christiana Bittio. Vimi Risha Bhagat. Abhiyev Bidani. Madeline Jean Bird. Mayor Rose Irene Toure Burkett. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Bao Yung Bong. Charles Dennis Bradley. Jean Robert Bradley. Brennan James Bramwell. Julia Kathleen Brown. Sam Robert Bryant. Jessica Joyce Chai. Jen Yung Chai. Daryl James Callanan. Caitlin Louise Campbell. Jonathan Brian Campbell. Peter James Carpenter. Ashley Monique Castle. Claudine Ann Bayuga Catrell. Chris Peter Kedanak. Hamish St. Clair Chatterton. Amanda Chuman Chan. Chi Yua Chan. Ho Man Chan. Chandler Ling. Kirti Kamal Chand. Shaohan Chang. Ji Sung Chang. Xiaohao Chang. Yunting Chan. Yunting Chan. Li Xuan Chao. Man Yu Chao. Chao Pui King. Bub Siok Chia. Alan Woon Hee Chen. Hai Jo Chen. Hidi Chan. Jia Chen Chan. Jia Yu Chan. Ting Xuan Chen. Ting Xuan Chen. Xiao Jia Chen. Yu Hua Chen. Yong Yun Cho. Biol Choi. Hun Wun Choi. Yun Sub Choi. Andrei Chukharev. Colin Chung. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Randall Paul Clement. Elise Jane Collins. Chung San Ying. Christopher Ian Connor. Mai Auroria Ojario Corpus. Aidan Douglas Costello. Darren Michael Coyne. Justin Roland Craig. Edward Allen Stiles Cran. Shane Quinton Crawford. Richard James D'Alessi. Achal Ashmita Dutt. Cameron James Davis. Carl Anthony Dawson. Iranga Hashika Diabru. Andrew Philip DeBorda. Senior Scholar, Business and Economic, Christian Tony DuPont. Zhi Chi Deng. Jaskrant Singh Dutt. Hao Ching D. Marcia Mary Saviola Diaz. Ching Ding. Ian Mark Delama. Logan John Driver. Debria Danielle D'Souza. Ashley Kane Dufty. Priyanka Dutt. Sally Ann Edgel. Dini Gianti Alazeta. Saimi Iom. Natalie Hasu Fakalogatoa. Juan Di Fun. Hamish George Fanslow. Sana Fahin. Tessa Allen Farley. Ding Chi Fung. Anthony Viani Finau. Equator Pascal Fitisimanu. Jamie Dominic Fitz. Cameron Paul Flood. Gary Cameron Fonua. Alex Wong Foy. Morgan Alice Foy. Hayden James Doval Francis. Matthew Peter Francis. Felia Frey. Hannah Jane French. Yingzhi Rachel Fung. Va Ying Gun. Chung Gao. Gauri Kishore Gopadi. Nicholas William Jin. Yi Mei Gore. Rung Bangung. Bruce Leslie Goodall. Nicola Louise Goodson. Arti Achana Gounda. Shifali Goel. Cornell Yen Ming Grace. Louis Jefferson Granger. Darren Richard Gray. Laura Ann Green. Matthew Lance Green. Xian Gu. Yuan Yura Gu. Chung Go. Rachel Alexandra Hedlow. Jack Fair Granville Hall. Ainsley Mary Ray Harrell. Chloe Usha Harry. Maggie Herr. Scott James Henderson. Sandaru Shavindi Hirath. Ashley Taylor Hill. Carl Vanelli Jr. Hill Willis. Kevin Ho. Ryan Henry Hung Yip Ho. Patrick William Hoban. Nicole Louise Hogarth. Charlotte Helen Hollier. Jessica Kelly Holmes. Yuan Ju Hong. Corey Ian Hooker. Shi Jie Ho. Shakelzen Hoxha. Johnny Ming Yin Su. Ken Ken Hu. Yan Ju Hu. Xiang Yun Huang. Jingjing Huang, Kit Ying Huang, Peter Wong, Fahed Sohail Hussain, Kwa Deng Huynh, Jordan Alana Abel, Uzar Ilahi, Iamema Ioyani, Alana Chanel Jackson, Anna Lara Jackson, Matthew Ivor Jacobson, Jessica Elizabeth Jeffries, Nicholas Robson Jensen, Jun Hook Jeong, Albert Jeong, Jia Jia, Jiang Huan, Hatel Kirit Javanji, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Tristan Philip Joe. Oliver Colin Johnson.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Hilary Hayes on violin, accompanied by Bradley Wood, will now perform Preludium and Allegro by Kressler. Thank you, Hilary and Bradley, for that beautifully played piece. I also wish to congratulate Hilary, who won first place in the graduation gala concerto competition last evening in the town hall. Can you all join with me in thanking Bradley and Hilary? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Whitred, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Chelsea Lara Jones. Gareth James Edward Jones. Gary Stephen Joseph. Jonathan Joseph. Salil Pradeep Joshi. Gloria Janelle Kam. Yik Ning Khan. Saifwan Khan. Won Bin Kang. Yu Li Kang. Dashaini Karupia Mohan. Finn Yudan Kasali. Caroline Astari Kazmara. Stefan Katic. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Michael Timothy Kelly. Craig Kenny. Christine Yeyui Ku. Kashta Kula. Anna Kiddick. Bora Kim. Dayun Kim. Hong Kyu Kim. Nung Sun Kim. Natalie Eloise Kirch. Vitaly Kirilenko. Joshua Kirkwood. Kavashek Vishal Kishore. Pei Yu Ko. Wei Liam Kong. Courtney Rachel Kosar. Amanpreet Kaur. Ashitosh Vijayant Kumar. Priya Dashani Kumar. Woo! Sonam Swastika Kumar. Thejan Dananjaya Karupa. Mok Yin Lai. Elliot Michael Lampo Tang. Hui Ling Selena Lam. Lisa Lam. Scott Michael Langdon. Scott Joseph Latham. Jun Yang Lau. Liko Fritz Lau. Nicole Elizabeth McPherson Laurie. Elena Dmitrievna Lekchinskaya. Stephen Lee Chi Kit. Eleanor Lees. Michaela Claudette Luenz. Elizabeth Joy Lewis. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint, Sahil Arora and a Bachelor of Science. Boris Babick and a Bachelor of Property. Svetlana Belyak and a Bachelor of Arts. Julia Rose Boyle and a Bachelor of Arts. Nicola Louise Carroll and a Bachelor of Arts. Elim Chan and a Bachelor of Science. Bradley Dean Chamali and a Bachelor of Property. Stephen Fanjo Chen and a Bachelor of Property. Yuhui Chen and a Bachelor of Property. Long Yu Sebastian Chung and a Bachelor of Arts. Patrick William James Charles and a Bachelor of Arts. Rebecca Elizabeth Clark and a Bachelor of Arts. Helen Patricia Collins and a Bachelor of Arts. Nicholas Lawrence Cullinane and a Bachelor of Arts. Maggie Ellen Davison and a Bachelor of Arts. Si Yuan Ding and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Ivana Drinkovic and a Bachelor of Arts. Robert James Fay and a Bachelor of Arts. Andrew James Peter Forshaw and a Bachelor of Science. Rachel Amy Gabriel and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Melissa Claire Goffin and a Bachelor of Arts. Dhruv Gomba and a Bachelor of Science. Catherine Frances Graham and a Bachelor of Science. Joyce Su Mei Ho and a Bachelor of Science. Sarah Jane Hodgkinson and a Bachelor of Arts. Joan Ting Kelly Huang and a Bachelor of Arts. Nita Yashrani and a Bachelor of Arts. Hiriya Kandaji Therome Judith Jayasinghe, and a Bachelor of Arts. Stephen Edward Jordan, and a Bachelor of Arts. Gahard Joseph, and a Bachelor of Arts. Biljan Darjeet Kaur, and a Bachelor of Arts. Anna Kathleen Kempkes, and a Bachelor of Arts. Mario Krestev, and a Bachelor of Science. Wai Leung Ku, and a Bachelor of Science. Judy Pui Yan Leung, and a Bachelor of Arts. Hin San Lee, and a Bachelor of Property. Yan Yin Lee, and a Bachelor of Arts. Xia Wen Lo, and a Bachelor of Arts. Pauline Pui Yin Lui, and a Bachelor of Arts. Shiwa Luk, and a Bachelor of Arts. Postgraduate Diploma in Business. Ali Babayi in Administration. Priscilla Edward Brito Pereira in Administration. Donna Marie Afra Campbell in Administration. Xian Ni Chen in Administration. Justine Amy Davies in Administration. Gary Bertram Gonsalves in Administration. Daria Gregiova in Administration. Haley Jane Gribble in Administration. Pavneet Grover, Administration. Dane Charles Guttenbeil in Administration. Raynor Mary Haag in Administration. Sarah Grace Pennington Ibbs, Administration. Jason Andrew Isaacs, Administration. Fawez Jabur, Administration. Ruth Jager, Administration. Vikas Jain, Administration. Carl Wayne Jones in Administration. Johnson Chun Sin Lau, Administration. Ruth Marlowe in Administration. Michael Joseph Matheson, Administration. Annette Marie McAinch in Administration. Damien Taylor Mokaraka, Administration. Derek Bart Pepesh, Administration. Jeremy Nicholas Parsons, Administration. Jonathan Robert James Payne, Administration. Artie Rothan, Administration. Glenn Darrell Roberts, Administration. Franklin Andalicio Saavedra Aravina, Administration. Samia Saxena, Administration. Damendra Singh, Administration. Mark Algurdas Skridulitis, Administration. Tanya Nicole Smith, Administration. Raymond James Stein, Administration. Stephen James Troughton, Administration. Mark Hendrik Van Swet, Administration. Zhu Kang Wong, Administration. Gordon Francis Whiffen, in Administration. Zhen Yu Chow, Administration. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours. Albert Ankiriwang in Finance. James Edward Brooker, Finance. University Graduate Scholar Julie J. Lin Chow in Finance. Kenny Kai Yin Chan in Accounting. Yi Lang Chan in Accounting. Mahesh Chagan in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce, Bachelor of Science conjoint. Jin Yong Choi, Marketing. Ian Robert Clatworthy, Accounting. Jessica Joy Cribbins, Marketing. Graham Peter Debney, Management. Andrew James Dodge, Marketing. Alice Amanda Fall, Marketing. Joyce Yingfei Guan in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Aileen Hu in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Benjamin David Inivali in Accounting. Benjamin Stanton Kiley in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Julie Kim in Operations and Supply Chain Management and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jae-ho Kwon, Accounting. Alexandra Frederick Leslie Lee Ben in Information Systems and a Bachelor of Commerce. Diane Perfume Christian Lavelula Amu in a Management. Yunjong Li in Accounting. Larissa Lutchman in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Pauline Delos Reyes Adviento in International Business and a Bachelor of Commerce. Xiao Yun An in Marketing. Daniel Mark Aldridge in Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Elizabeth Ann Bond in Information Systems and a Bachelor of Commerce. Shi Sao in Accounting. Anna Dodoka in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Fu Donggao, Economics. Owen Luke Isaacson in International Business. Matthew Johnson, Marketing. Aaron Richard Krebs, Economics. Alice Yen Noral Lum, Finance. Sung Yun Lee, Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Andrew Hilton Godecki in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Lily He, International Business. Nino Temuraz Inanishvili in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jia Yao Kim in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. Wei Cheng Lian in Economics. To the degree of Master of Business Administration, Lyndon Wallace Finlayson Bain. Marcus Terence Gordon Bosch. Andrew Jonathan Boys. Emma Louise Brooks. David John Bryant. Aitung Chan. Vineet Balsavish Chwahan. Nicola Jan Cheeseman. Yuan Yu Chen. Catherine Nancy Grace Churcher. Jody Louise Cottle. Jason Robert Cox. Paul de Quaster Niet. Timothy Warnock Diprose. Yuna Robin Diver. Andrew Christopher Ewens. Scott Ronald Fenton. Hashim Juan Chua, and a postgraduate diploma in business administration. Joanna Margolatsa Yashchemska. Fiona Barbara Kingsford. Fergus Leon Hock Lee. Elizabeth Margaret Lindsay, and a postgraduate diploma in business and administration. Wendy Mary Mainwaring. Paul Anthony Matthews. Matthew George Mays. Diane Victoria Mikatia. Gary Christopher McIlvaina. Gavin Keith Peebles. Marcus Julian Pillay. Jonathan David Rhodes. Jessica Marie Seamark. Wei Yong Seat. Richard Brian William Seymour Wright. Sneha Savotham Shetty. Giuseppe Simonetta. Sashi Sajeev Singh. Paul James Smith. Shama Sukul. Murray Charles Taylor. Catherine Louise Tyler, and a postgraduate diploma in business and administration. Lyndon Jan Vasey. Neil George Watson. Julianne Wilson. To the degree of Master of Commercialization and Entrepreneurship, Michael David Eagleson. Graham Robert Finch. Jem Mikhail Carl Frederick Lawrenson. Barbara McArdle. Owen O'Sullivan. Dimas Simon Segovia Munoz. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with First Class Honours, Natasha Cheryl Delamore. Daniel John Hicks. Kylene Isabel Sinamoe Nike Leong. Christina Kiri Wirihana. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with Second Class Honours First Division, Kwok Yi Gloria Chung. Gung Jerry Dung. K. Patricia Highland. Alistair Bruce Marsh. Samar Pant, and a Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division in Commercial Law. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Sachin Baldev Kumar Modgill. Donna Gail Vincent. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies, Myong Hee Choi.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Azu Atik in Information Systems. Azu investigated the design and provision of technology-enabled services that led to the development of a collaborative service system design model. This empirically constructed model stresses the seamless inclusion of consumers in the design of technology-enabled services. Azu. Rosalind Frances Bosworth in Management University Doctoral Scholar. Rosalind investigated innovation dynamics and practices of firms successful in the development of groundbreaking environmental and sustainable innovations. A dynamic business innovation model was developed for use by companies and industry practitioners as a means of enhancing the environmental sustainability of business innovations. Rosalind. Amabel Jai Hunting in Marketing, University Doctoral Scholar. Amabel explored what it means for urban-based consumers to live sustainably in New Zealand. Amabel. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Business and Economics.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for innovation in teaching has been made to Dr. Charlotta Windall in the Department of Marketing within the Faculty of Business and Economics. I call upon a student of that faculty, Isabel Monk, to read the citation for Dr. Windall.
Dr. Charlotta Windall is a passionate and engaging teacher with a contagious enthusiasm for learning and for design thinking. She goes above and beyond expectations in her work and is a very worthy recipient of this award. I am speaking today on behalf of the students of Lotta's undergraduate course, Services Marketing and Management, a course which she has led since 2011. There are many things which make Lotta stand out as a teacher. She has a non-traditional approach to content delivery, which we as students enjoyed. Lotta's vision is to inspire and encourage students to think and act without telling them what to think and how to act. At the start of the course, she said to us, "I want you to be like young children. Question everything and keep asking why." Lotta teaches by showing the students where to look, but not what to see. She encouraged us to be active learners, learning from doing, trying, failing, making improvements. Her students come away prepared with skills for work outside of university. We will need to be able to deal with change and uncertainty. Lotta is highly engaged with her students, and this was a common theme in student feedback from the course. Lotta went through the struggles and the successes of our design challenge projects with us. In the classroom, Lotta is not only a teacher, she is also learning alongside her students. She constantly looks for ways to improve the course, seeking feedback from students all the time, and even making changes within the semester. Personally, I gained a huge amount from this course, and Lotta is a real inspiration for me. The Award for Teaching Excellence is a fantastic recognition of Lotta's hard work. I congratulate her on this achievement.
We are nearing the conclusion of the formal part of this ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And while you are still standing, this would be a good time for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of council and convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme.